action this morning. How many of you have ever done something you knew you wasn't supposed to do and you got caught and the first thing you did was you start crying? Tear up. Everybody raise your hand in here. Yeah, done that. Come on.
Forget it high.
Hey, I'll raise my hand because I've done the same thing. You know, I got busted. Oh, dadgum. You know, and those fears started flowing. But guess what? Those fears don't really mean anything if it doesn't change.
That's right.
All right.
Come on. You know, if it doesn't change you in the least bit,
yes.
Repentance leads us to turn completely from sin and ourselves and rely on God to save us through Christ. All right? So let's shed some tears of joy this morning. And if you're here this morning and you're lost and you don't know Him, I'd love to see somebody shed some tears of joy this morning.
Amen.
243.
Broke the bonds of prison for me. I call.
2:21.
Watches over me while I sleep, hears me when I pray. I'm as happy as.
Thank you. and she says, "Sir, sir, sir." And I thought, goodness, she's not talking to me, you know. And she said, "Can I see your ticket?" And I got to look, and I thought, well, I don't know what I've done with it. And Isaac said, "I got your ticket." So we hand it to the lady. She sees that we had paid and everything. And I thought, boy, ain't that something. They treat everybody in here like a criminal. Like I was trying to shoplift or steal or something. Well, this morning I want to treat everybody in this place the same way. Not as a criminal, but with love and with affection that only God can give us.
Amen.
And I want this morning you to hear my heart and hear the urgency of this message that the Lord has laid upon our heart this morning. Because I'm going to be honest with you, it wasn't long ago Brother Josh Hill was preaching revival down at Davis Chapel. And I knew the message that he had preached that night was hard for him to preach. Because when the Lord lays a message like that on a man's heart, it's for somebody. And this is that same type of message. It's not an easy message to preach, but it's needful. And it's for somebody, and I believe that somebody is here because I didn't know who was going to be here this morning, but the Lord did.
Amen.
So if you would read with me the book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, it's a very familiar passage of Scripture, verse number 12. It says that you may walk honestly toward them that are without, that ye may have lack of nothing. Lack of nothing. But I would not have you to be ignorant, brethren, concerning them which are asleep, that you sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also which sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you, by the word of the Lord, that we which are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them which are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, with the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. And we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. Wherefore comfort one another with these words. Brother Josh Hill, would you pray for me?
Our dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for allowing us to come out and worship you one more time. Lord, we ask you, Lord, to touch John this morning as he brings your word. Lord, we know that your word is sure this morning. It cuts like a two-edged sword this morning. But God, Lord, we ask that each and every one of us have open hearts and open minds, that we receive it, God, exactly how you have it meant for us this morning. But Lord, I ask this morning, if there's one here that don't know you from free pardon of sin, Lord, that when you touch that heart this morning, you convict their heart this morning, that they come and don't wait, God. But Lord, I ask you to touch John this morning, hide him behind the cross, Lord. Let him just be a mouthpiece for you, Lord, that he increases, that you may increase this morning. We thank you, we pray in your sweet name. Amen.
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 Amen. This morning, I've got a very simple outline that I want to share with you, but it's going to take a little while. So I want you to stay with me, if you would, at 1948. And the Bible says that this generation shall not pass away until they see this coming of the Son of Man in the clouds with power and with great glory. You need to understand this morning what you people ask their question. They say, what's left that's got to take place before the rapture? The answer's nothing. Not one thing is holding Christ back from coming and rapturing his church out of this place right now today. and it's profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction. And it's all Scripture. So when you read something in the book of 1 Thessalonians, you can mark it down that it was breathed by Almighty God, and it was breathed there and put there for our benefit. The time is set and the text is sure.
Amen.
The last moment, the trump will sound. The trump will sound. Now listen to what I'm telling you this morning. That not long ago, I got to share a story with you before I do. Not long ago, we put to rest Brother Ronald Shanks, a member of this church. And God, I want to tell you something. I miss that man. I love that man.
Amen.
He was a come in these altars already this morning. If you've got somebody this morning that you need to pray for that you know is not ready, I'm going to ask you to invite you to this altar to come.